got a live stream with Streamyard. Yes, you guys, this is one of my favorite tools. Streamyard is one of the best ways that a newbie can get started to do live streams on the internet, share their screen at the same time, have really cool, fun graphics come through, and you don't have to be a genius or a tech goddess like myself to learn how to use it. So today I'm going to share with you a tutorial on a walkthrough that I did that I've actually been walking my clients through multiple times. So I'm like, I might as well do a video on it, right? So if you're new to the channel, make sure to like and subscribe to this channel. I love teaching and training people how to use tools that make their lives easier. And this is one of them, you guys, StreamYard. StreamYard is one of the best ways that you can go live in your Facebook group, just even on your Facebook profile, actually even multiple platforms, YouTube, Periscope, like you can actually go live on Twitch as well too. You can actually be streaming all at the same time. And the best part of it is that it actually creates a post on your Facebook page or wherever you're going to live stream. You can pre-schedule an event and you can just drive people to that post before you even go live. So here's the thing. One of my clients, actually many of them go live. And if you're using Zoom or something like that, it's a great, you know, I've been using Zoom for a while to do one-on-one meetings, go live on your Facebook pages and things like that, as well as record and everything. And StreamYard does that too. But the thing is, it does not pre-schedule a post like StreamYard does, where I can actually do a lot of the pre-promoting of that post within about a week's time. So it'll schedule at least about 7 days out. So I'm doing a live stream next week at this time. I can schedule it right now and I'm going to show you how I do it and all the different features in the next part of this video. So let's go into it for you. We're going to log in. One thing I wanted to mention is that if you sign up, use the link in my description, of course, but when you put your email in here, it's going to send you a code and it's a one-time code thing. And I have to do it every time I log in and out, because if I log into someone else's account, then I have to have their email. So if you are a social media manager like myself, you do have to get access to their email or ask people, ask them to get into their email. So let me get my email out real quick. Hold on a second. Okay, baby. Okay, put in the code. All right, so we have the creative broadcast section, but first we're going to need to set up destinations. I have only two spots that I can stream, and there's several different places you can stream. I'm going to show you, but the package that I have only allows me to do two at the same time. If you want more than that, then there's another package that you can stream in all these places, pretty much. A Facebook page, your Facebook group, Facebook profile, Twitch, Restream, LinkedIn, YouTube. Mainly I want to do is go live in my Facebook group and my YouTube channel at the same time. I'm basically killing two birds with one stone, right? With one video. So I love to do that. So all I need to do is click on it and it just, you know, goes to your verification. Same thing with YouTube. You pull up your account. Let me go over here. And so I already set these up. And I can remove them and I can switch them to different accounts too if I wanted to. And so I can actually just show you how it works right now. So I might as well just redo it so that you can see exactly what you go through when you set up your YouTube channel. You do, you know, it opens up your Google account that you're connected to with YouTube. So I'm going to do that and show you how it works. This is very user friendly, guys. If you are, I'm going to pull up my YouTube channel brand. I have actually several brand accounts in that I manage. So this is what happens. Normally you'll just see your one account. I have like a couple, a lot. So you just follow the prompts and that's it. You're all set. I've worked with other softwares where it was a lot more complicated than that. And I can simply create a broadcast, but I want to do one more destination. That's my Facebook group. Add Facebook group and connect. This is the thing, guys. This is like my strategy and what I teach my students is to go live at least once a week. And, you know, that's like a minimum. You guys do at least once a week. You know, build your brand, give value in your trainings and offerings that you do live. So plan one live stream a week. Streamyard makes it so simple. We're going to create a broadcast. I'm going to select the two that I want to stream. You can just do one if you want to. But what I like about Streamyard is that with the paid, you know, subscription one, and you can test it out too. You can get a free subscription right now. Click the link in the description and get a free, you know, account, free trial. And then you can also get $10 off if you decide that you really love it like I do. So let's do this. Let's do a live stream tomorrow. Okay, better title. How we got 100 people live in our recent challenge group. I think that will be a hit. So you can schedule it for later. I just pulled in a picture, but you can have a thumbnail ready. You can schedule it for whatever time. You can do it at least 7 days out. So I'm going to click here. But you want to make sure that you're on time or else it'll get deleted from Facebook. You can click customize for each destination. So if you want to change what it looks like. Oh, sorry. It's saying today. That's why. Tomorrow. If I wanted to make it different, like different description for Facebook and a different description for YouTube, I can do that here. And I can even have a different thumbnail if I wanted to in the different platforms. So there is editing capabilities on each platform. And that's simple. That's it. You literally schedule it out ahead of time. And this is what I mean. I'm going to show you inside of my Facebook group and on YouTube that it's pre-scheduled. Now people can actually go over there and see that I'm going to go live. So tonight or whenever from now until the time that it's going live, it'll show up as a post. And I'm going to show you what it looks like here. And they can click get reminder. And I don't have to worry about pre-promote. I mean, I can pre-promote it, but I don't have to worry about them showing up because once they see this post, they're going to click on get reminder. And that's going to help me get them to this live stream without having to be like, hey, just refresh in the group. Make sure to show up. Make sure, you know, like getting it in their brain to show up at that time so that you can get more people to your live stream. This is what I'm trying to tell my clients and my students why I love StreamYard, because it will pre-schedule it. You can do this in Ecamm Live. And this is why I love Ecamm Live. But the problem with Ecamm Live maybe I should do another video on the differences between the other competitors. But problem is if I want to do a joint venture or do an interview type of video, Ecamm Live, I can do that, but I need to have them on Skype. Like, who does Skype these days? Like, I don't know who Skypes anymore. Like, we FaceTime now. So Streamyard, I don't have to have a specific type of software. I just give them a link. This is what you do. If you're inviting a guest, you go over here to more and click invite guest, and all you need to do is send them this link, and you can email them, either Gmail or, you know, just go and copy this link to your clipboard and send them the link. And all they need to do is click on the link. They can even use it on mobile. They do need to copy that link into the Safari or their browser on their mobile phone, and they can do the interview with you from their mobile phone. You can also screen share. This is the best part, guys. You can screen share. So today I did a live stream with my friend Andrew from TubeBuddy. So if you didn't see that last video, go check it out. But literally we shared our screen. So this is what happens when you go into the broadcast studio. You have your name. You can put whatever your name, nickname, or whatever. You can check your camera, check your volume here. You can just click here to select the right camera. Where are my blue light glasses, guys? Check the right, you know, if you want it to be muted, check your mic, check the audio. If you wanted to do green screen here, you can do green screen. I don't know how to do that since I don't have a green screen, but you enter the broadcast studio, and I'm going to walk you through like an overview here. But what happens is you have yourself on the bottom left here. You need to click this plus button so it pops you in there. And then when your guest shows up, it doesn't bell. There's no bell or anything. So make sure that there is that you keep an eye out, and they basically just pop up in the bottom here, like I did. Like this. And so when you see it, you have to click them in, and they go into the studio here, and they come next to you right here. So there's like two options where you have two people. And if you want to see that example, you can see one of my live streams, and you can switch, you know, you can share screen. There was a glitch this afternoon, where my friend couldn't bring in his screen. So he had to just basically, he logged out and just refreshed and came back in, and it was fine. For some reason, it had a weird permission thing. So no biggie, just want to let you guys know. And this is why you watch my videos, right? So you know the little glitches or things to avoid and things to do. So you can share your screen. You can have a couple people on here. You can have three people on here. You can, again, if you don't know where the code is, if you're there and you're like waiting for your friend, you can invite your friend right there. There's the invite link right here. When you go live, you just click the top here and go live. There's a countdown here that starts counting down when you get closer. Here's the comments. This is where all the comments are gonna show up. So this is an example. Don't click on this if you're like live, but this is what the comments look like. If someone starts commenting, this is an example of what it could look like. It also will color code if it's coming from Facebook or YouTube or whatever platform the comment came from. You can also make sure to go down here and you can, you know, message everyone, or you know, you can message from specific accounts or all destinations. Click that. Cool. If you want to talk to just the other person, on your guests, you can click private chat here. This is the cool part, branding. Okay. If you wanted this color, your name, to be a different color, you can put your brand color here. You can have several different brand colors. So I have different companies that I actually do live streams for, and you can have their logo show up here. See, this is one of the companies I work for is Real Estate Funnel System. So I have their logo. When we do live streams together, we have their logo up there. Here's the example logo that is powered by StreamYard. You just basically upload your logo here. Of course, you need to have the back of the image with as transparent as possible. You can use a PNG file. And if you click on the question mark here, it show you this, you know, this, the sizing. Here's the overlay, and it'll show you the size as well. And if you have a small like clip that you want to do that's less than 30 seconds, maybe you can do like put your intro in there, and you can upload the layout here. Just show layout here. If you want to do an overlay, which that's fun, I've created overlays for clients too. And then you can have a different background too. And that's only if you're like doing like these different views, you can see the background. Let's see if I can show you. I can't see the background on this one. If you want to turn off the display names, you can do that here. Turn it on and off. And then you can start seeing people over here, right? When it's like, when people start, you know, showing up live, and someone already hearted it because I posted it, scheduled. So that's the branding. Banners. This is the cool thing, guys. I had this banner, like this one I did with a ticker on the bottom. So I click, let me show you this. The coupon code is like scrolling on the bottom. Sorry, let me see. There you go. That's what it looks like. Or you can have a banner where it's just has the name, you know, like maybe you want to have talking points and you're like, get more views, or a website. You don't have to have it scrolling. Like I clicked this button to have it scrolling around the bottom. But if you want to just have that, you can add banner, and then you can just like show it like, hey, in this video, we're going to talk about how to get more views, right? And so you can have that show up. Doesn't that look cool? Or you can turn it off. So that's that. And here's all the different, it makes you look like a boss. So that is my overview of StreamYard. If you have more questions, let me know.
If you love StreamYard as much as I do, make sure to click the link in the description so you can get $10 off. Of course, I get an affiliate commission, total disclaimer. So hopefully you found my video valuable on how to use it, all the features, why you should use it to go live and get your message out into the world, and also look like a boss with using this platform. You don't need a Mac. You don't need to, you know, have a certain type of computer. You literally, it's web-based, I believe. It's, you know, you go on Chrome, and the only thing is that if you are, like myself, a social media person and you're running this for somebody else, you do have to have their login to their email, because every time you log in, it remembers who you are. But for the first time, you actually have to get a code. So when I switch through different StreamYard accounts for my customers or my students, I have to make sure I have their email so that I can get in from this side. So hopefully that makes sense. If not, you can let me know in the comments below. I can do a tutorial about it. If I didn't go into depth or if I missed anything. But of course, you guys, you know what to do. Much love and aloha. Make sure to like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next video. Bye. Bye, mommy. Mommy. Yeah, bye.